Hello, good evening. This is Sajit, and here I am going to demonstrate you to set up our MT server. So you can see this visual here where you have a set of client connecting to the RMT, and RMT having, you know, in further RMT is going to connect to the SCC all through the firewall. So RMT is more like an update server, which is used to manage the update as well as the subscription. So you can think of it like you have a customer, some product they are using it. Let's say we have X number of machines running here and we need an update. So the one way can be like each client can connect to SCC directly. That can be the one way. Second is you can place one SUSE manager system here in between the client and the SCC. A third can be RMT. So in the first way, means where the client can connect to the SCC, the disadvantage of this architecture is it may happen that all the clients are downloading the same file. It always happens when you update your machine. You might have seen that where the clients are doing the same job, which will, you know, downgrade the performance of the network, right? It also consumes some data. The same data is going to be downloaded into all the machines. So what I need to have some middleman, some machines in between client and SCC to help them out. So either you can place a SUSE manager. So SUSE manager is a full flash infrastructure management and configuration tool, right? So SUSE manager is a full flash, as I said, that with SUSE manager you can manage your subscription activation key. You can do some provisioning, etc. RMT is going to deal with update and entitlement and subscription only. So if your concern is to manage the update, I think RMT is a good way to do that. So see how we do that. Here I have a machine, the one is management, which is working as my RMT server, which will work as a RMT server, and the second one, master, will be working as my client. So let's go to my management machine, which is RMT. So yeah, so the steps are very straightforward. First you have to configure DNS. DNS should be there. All the machines should have, you know, working with the DNS. The second is NTP need to be configured, because RMT required to configure a certificate. So for certificate, time should be, you know, correct. So NTP need to be there, either global NTP or local NTP. So concern is the downline is all the machine have a same correct zone and time. That's it. Third one is firewall. Yes, either you can for testing environment you can stop either, or you need to configure it properly. Then the next step is you have to install the package to configure RMT, which is zipper install RMT server. Then you have to run yaz2 space rmt. So when you run this command yaz2 space rmt, it will ask you to fix the password for your database. It asks you to supply a credential for certificates. So there are three or four steps there to do that. Right. Then after, once this process is done, you can check, you can run this command systemctl status rmt server sync timer, which is used to synchronize the repository metadata. And the second one is this one, rmt server mirror timer, which is to, you know, mirroring the packages. So once this thing is done, you have to run RMT sync, which is going to sync, the RMT is going to sync with SCC to update their database, their repository, right? After that, you have to, in between, after SCC, you have to select your product that you want to, you know, download. So yes, you have to select a product. Then after, you have to run a mirroring. So in my case, I have done all these steps, meaning is all these steps are already done, because this step 9 takes almost 3 to 4 GB space, and I did this already, so I don't think to rerun this command again and re-download the same patch. But yes, I will help you out to set up or to configure the client under in RMT. So as I said that you have to run this command. Let's run this up. Let's see. Yes, to RMT. It is done already. I can show you something. So yes, the first step is it says that here you have to supply your organization credential. So you must have a your account in SCC, and if you have an account, definitely you would have the organization username and organization password. So you have to supply it. I supplied it already. The next. It's saying database already configure, SCC certificate is already configure, last firewall is configure, and starting it. So there are four phases. The one is the step one is to supply the mirroring credential. You can find this from the SCC account. I can show you something. So if you go there in SCC, under in proxy section, under in proxy section, you can find this your username and some credential, right? So you have to copy this and paste it there, right? So yeah, I done this job, this is steps already, and then after you have to select the product that you want to download. So there is a command called RMT space CLI product list hyphen hyphen all. So you can see all the product that you are entitled for. So when I list it up, you can see I have let's see from the top. You have a product ID, product name, version architecture, mirror or last mirror. So let's say you can see I have done this base system module, which is SLI SP1. Actually, my client machine is SLI 15 SP1, and I need this product, so I sync it. How to do? The syncing step is very first you have to enable this product. So RMT, it is there already in the slide, the step slide, product enable, and the number in my case it is 1772. So when I click this, the product will enable. So you have to choose all the product that you need with the same way. And then in the last, when you select all the product, you have to run RMT hyphen CLI and mirror. That's all. Right. So first you have to select the product, then you have to run the mirror command. Mirror command is going to download the update down from the server to the client to your machine, right? So I've done this job already, and yes, right, okay. Now it is a time to register a client. So here I have a client, master. Yes, and I can show you whether it is registered or not. So no, it is not yet registered. You can see here we have a registered via SCC directly, right? So register system via management, okay, not SCC, management. The second one is via SMT, and the last one is skip. So let's say you are running a SUSE manager. So in that case, select the first option, the first one, if you are running a SUSE manager. If you are running some update server like RMT or SMT there, then you have to select second. The last one is skip. So yes, my machine is not registered, so I need to register. I want to register. So these are two steps only to run it. So I'm supposed to run this on my Yes. Write a correct name of your management.example.com. Here you have a file called RMT. Yeah, you can see this file hold all the configuration required to register this machine under RMT. Now the next and last command is this one. So management.example.com, enter. So yes, here we go. So yes, you have learned how to register a machine, Linux machine, under in RMD. So I'm going to stop this now. Have a good day. Thank you.